This conference
Welcome.
will now be recorded.
Hi everyone, welcome to this another video in Marketab YouTube channel. So today you can see the thumbnail here. So all the traders, retailers, investors, everybody's selling buy on dips. Analysts are still saying same thing. Nifty will tilt 20,000, 40,000 bank Nifty will touch in another 2-3 months or before end of the year. All the dips are being bought. You see a small dip also comes, everybody's just buying, nothing else. And now everybody has the FOMO, fear of missing out. And Corona has killed the bears. It will take several months for the bears to come reborn again. So this is thumbnail here. This is what in the market, what's happening here as of now. So stay cautious with the bulls and don't be big time on the bulls or long positions. Stay cautious. That's the only thing I would like to tell before starting the video. Before going to the video, disclaimer, the views what I mentioned is videos of personal opinion and any loss incurred by taking your trades based on your views are not responsible. Please consider financial advice before taking any trades. So the first thing is the FI data. Let us see the FI data now. FI just bought some small amount of 425 contracts and bought some stock futures. Still it is low position only and they're just trying to exit some time whenever possible time. Possible they may exit on this long futures in the expiry day. We have to wait and watch. If you see here the long short ratio, it was around 87.6, slightly has come to 86.6. So just holding on to the positions and trying to exit at the right time. If something happens at the big move on the downside, maybe big movements at least 300, 400 points in the bank Nifty, some correction if it all comes, then the expiry day will be a very good time for making money for the bears actually. So possible that they're waiting for the positions by FIs. And in case of clients, if you see here, the clients are just holding the short positions here and put option short also the holding and the long call short also the holding. And in case of Propel traders, they also holding the index futures short and here they're holding the hedge position here. So this is status. There's not much of the movement here, but everybody is waiting for the bears to come and the cautiously going long positions. And they don't want to just go on the gung-ho on the bullish side. That's the actual scenario actually. But today, okay, cash market, I couldn't get the data actually, there was some problem. Maybe we'll try later. And coming to the FO defino data, the highest open interest still at 3500 call option, which is trading at around 212 rupees. And the put option is around only 8 lakh rupees, 8 lakh contracts. So possible that 3500 above that we may not expire. And 35,000 surprisingly, if you see yesterday, 35,000 put option, the put option was almost like 10 lakh 22,000 contracts. Now, it has slightly increased to 10 lakh 47,000 actually. So possible that the fall, they are not afraid, 35,000 put option, that is they are not afraid. And possible that these people, unless they square up the positions, you may break 35,000. Otherwise, 35,000 should get protected. And worst come worst basis, we can expire at 35,000 level. But sometimes the market will threaten these people also, 35,000 put option traders also. Here, if you see the highest open interest, 35,500 call option, highest open interest here, and then next 35,000 put option. So there is a big gap here, and the put option traders are ready for the move to 35,000 level also. If 35,500 put option is threatened, then they will go to 35,000 put option. But as of now, they are equally holding the put option, call option, and there is no much of, if you see here, highest 17 lakhs of call option trading is there, and only 10 lakhs of put trading is there. So there is a selling pressure is heavy on the call options actually. That is the reason PCR has gone to 0.69 in bank Nifty. And in case of Nifty, Nifty is super bullish. There is no issue at all. Every dip is being bought by FIs, DIs, retailers, investors, traders, everybody. Nobody is left out. There is no sellers at all in the Nifty actually. So completely is only buying happening in the Nifty and nothing is happening, selling in the, happening in the Nifty completely actually. So forget about the bears in the Nifty for time being. If at all some correction comes, maybe 100 points, 150 points correction can come. As of now, it's very, very strong bullish in case of Nifty. If you see PCR, it has not given touch 1 actually today. This is 1.09. However, bank Nifty PCR is 0.69. And coming to open interest change today, yesterday 22 lakhs of bullish position was created at the bank Nifty, but today exactly double of that, 47 lakhs of bearish position got added actually. and the PCR has gone to 0.69. If next 2 days before expiry, if we break this, like maybe like 0.55, some PCR comes and then we can touch the bottom and we can touch 35,000 levels on intraday basis at least. Intraday basis, and we can test 35,000 and some see some range bound moves, and then we can close on 35,000 also possibly. But the momentum, if it is supported by the Nifty on the downside, because today after adding 1 crore of bullish version yesterday, immediately the market has given away all the profits. Actually, not the point wise, there is only 8% correct, 8 points correction only. But the bearish portion got added actually, 89 lakhs of bearish portion got added actually. And if the 36 lakhs also got cleared, then some good down moves can come in the Nifty. Down moves means maybe 100 points, 150 points, that's it, nothing more than that. Because if every dip is being bought actually, unless everybody is completing the exhausting their money, then only the market can give some good correction and the down moves actually. Till the time everybody have liquidity, the money power is there, muscle power is there for the big traders, investors, and the market is going to be on upside only. Liquidity driven rally this is. Fundamental also is okay, there is no issue on that. But no, everything over the long period of time, the market can definitely be on upside only. But for time being, some correction is required for healthy movement on the upside actually. Because without correction, if the market keeps on moving up, then there is no charm also in the market. And here, if you see June, let us see June 2021 here. If you see here, as I mentioned yesterday, 3 crores is the top maximum. 3 to 3.5 crores is normally we are seeing a top actually in case of Nifty. And today we corrected almost 80 lakhs. Very special got added actually. So, but the thing is surprising thing is only 8 points we got corrected in case of Nifty, in spite of 80 lakhs of bearish position got added in Nifty. So stay cautious with Nifty because some negative divergence is visible in the option data. And in case of Bank Nifty also, the momentum is there actually. If tomorrow also if we see some gap up, then the good opportunity to buy the put option. So today morning also I mentioned Telegram channel about 3500 put option, which is around 230. And hope many of you have enjoyed the profits in the 3500 put option. After that, I booked the profit in almost 350, around 130 points of profit I booked. But the market, the 3500 put option went all the way to 450 also. Actually. And again, by 2 o'clock, we reached almost 250 level. And again, we reached 400 level. Okay. So two opportunities we got in 3500 put option actually. So trading on both sides will be difficult actually. So handle only one side. Handle only one instrument, either Nifty or Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty means then handle one side call or put, and also in the call or put handle one strike price and become specialist in that and try to capture the movements. There's two opportunities we get here, say 200 points you're getting in the Bank Nifty and also in the option. So even if you just make four, eight lots, something like that, you make good money actually in the Bank Nifty because you're getting a movement in the both sides, call and put both. And the PCR we saw bearish Bank Nifty and bullish Nifty. And support we can see here, stagnation we can see 35,300, there is no improvement. And here also 15,500, there is no improvement in the support. Just we are standing in the same place. But in case of Nifty, the Bank Nifty, 35,200, as I mentioned here, the maximum upside was 36,200 roughly. But we could not even cross that level, and just before itself we got came down here. And in case 35,200 level is broken, 35,200 level is broken on downside, then it's going to be a problem. This lower straddle, stay cautious here. 35,200. Then case of Nifty, we have again stagnation here, 15,600. Possibly that we can see 15,500 maximum. I don't see much beyond the below 13,500 because every even dip of 10-20 points also everybody is buying, and short covering rally plus people are buying in the equity like anything, and that is the reason that market is keep on going. The money power has to exhaust, then only the correction can come in the Nifty particularly. Bank Nifty is definitely weak, there is no doubt about that, because in spite of Nifty making new high, Bank Nifty is not making any new high at all. That is the biggest weakness. So Lakshman Rekha, as of now it's bullish only, there is no issue at all. 35,000 level in the futures has to come down, and in case of Nifty, 15,360-370 level has to be broken on downside, then only some bearishness can come. But in case of midpoint, weekly midpoint, we have that also both correlating with the 35,000 level. So 35,000 level is going to be very, very, very important level for the Bank Nifty in the futures. And in case of Nifty also, the 15,340 is a very important level, 300-340 zone. Once it breaks it, then some correction can come. Say 200 points or 300 points, that correction can come. But since everybody is buying on the dips, I'm not expecting major correction to come. But FIs has to come and not put the pressure on downside, then the market can go down. Without FIs pressure, the market cannot go down at all. This is very important because FIs are the only muscle power to pull down the market actually. Otherwise, DAs doesn't have the authority and the retailers doesn't have the interest. If that is not there, then who will bring down the markets? Only FIs are there who can bring down the markets. Others are traders only, just doing a defensive trades. The market is moving down, buying the put or selling the calls. That's what others do. But the main source of the main controlling power who is pushing the market on downside or upside is only FIs. There is nobody else. On the upside, DAs can buy and push the market on the upside. But downside, only FIs can do that. Just remember that. And in case of a pivot point, Nifty's keep on going only upside. There is no downside. It doesn't know what is downside. So we have to wait for the Nifty to correct if it all comes. Until the time, enjoy the upside. There is no issues. Just trading against the market, there is no point in trading against the market. That is very dangerous. So Bank Nifty, some sluggishness is there. As you see, the PCR of Bank Nifty only can lead to something else. Nifty also, in case, because Nifty is very strong from Reliance, actually. Reliance and IT stocks. IT stocks are trying to manage the show. And Bank Nifty is not able to pull down the Nifty, actually. Because all these days, Reliance was sleeping, but after Bank Nifty became weak, then Reliance became active and started moving on the upside actually. So levels for tomorrow. So yesterday, there was a problem actually in updating my data. So I now automated this. So everything will come automatically. So there is a manual intervention here. So these are levels for the Nifty and Bank Nifty spot levels. So I don't want to put the futures and confuse. So better I put the Nifty and Bank Nifty spot levels for tomorrow. You can just take note. And VIX has gone up by 3%, slightly not good for bulls. But however, till we don't cross 25 levels in VIX, there is no issue at all. It can be clear bull run only. And the cash market, today some weakness was seen and the investors or traders were selling some stocks. If you break this level, 20 moving average, then only some weakness can come in the overall broader market actually. And coming to the levels, actually you will see here today, if you see here 35,000 up to 35,000 34,000, all these call options, okay, let me just see, all the call options were sold only here today, completely was selling happening in the call options. And here in case of put, here also selling was seen, only some buying was seen higher in the money put options, which is 35,600 put option. And here also like the 35,500, if you see 35,500 put option is what you have to focus today. We have seen that actually. Let us focus 35,500 put option. So 35,500 put option today selling about 230. It went to made a low 221, 10 points only. After that, it made a high of 455. So our second time also we got opportunity at 250 level. Then again we got to touch 400. So the moving average is 461. So in case 341, 43, it crosses this level. So 455, 460, 450, 460 level. If it crosses, then some trending down move can come. Then only the put option traders can become a little fearful and do some covering of the put option shorter. But otherwise, then there will be no issues because it's just a range bound movement. Because it has traveled all the way to 1,824, the put options here, the high it made, around 1,200, the high it made actually 24th May. And then now we are trading at around 343. So only the problem will be if it crosses 455, or something like that, some touches some the higher level, then the put option traders can be a problem. Because already if you see here, 8 lakhs of openers is sealed for the put option, 35,500. So one lakh of openers was added actually. And in case of 35,500 call option, 5 lakhs of put option was added, and openers were added actually. So the high is broken, the yesterday's high actually, but could not sustain and closed, went almost as low of yesterday. And the close below the yesterday's close, very much in the downside actually. So you need to always observe the high, low and close, very, very important. So tomorrow our focus will be on 35,000 in case there is a gap up. If there is a gap up again, we'll focus on 35,500. So I'm not expecting that same level should come in case we don't break 300. There is a gap up and we don't break 300, then it's again a buy option, opportunity for a put options. And in case there is a gap down, then it will be a buying opportunity for the call options. Or if there is assumed there is a dip actually. Let us see here. Let me just see. See tomorrow if this bank Nifty 35,000, there is a not ready. Assume there is a gap down of say 150 or 200 points. So then 35,300 is what you have to observe. Actually. So in that case, what are the near strike price? What we are seeing a gap down there. So 35,300 call option, if we let us just take 35,300 call option, the low is 279, we closer to 310. So 35,300 call option, if it comes around 200, something like that. Assume tomorrow at gap down, we get it around 200 and something like 250. 200 should not break. I'm not expecting 200 to break for 35,300 call option. If we get around this level, then you have to buy 35,300 call option and look for the ride all the way to 400 levels also possible. Okay, so tomorrow you have to focus on 35,300 call option if there's a gap down, and if there's a gap up, then you have to focus on 35,500 put option. That also will be around 200-250 levels. So whatever is around 200-250 levels, you have to just focus on 35,300 call option or 35,500 put option. These two things are going to give you a good reward at the initial opening of the day of the market. And option price analysis, we saw this already. Okay, now going to the chart section today, what happened? So we'll see some stocks actually also starting from what I'm trying to see. So Adani Ports here, we gave a breakout of a long breakout around 1 o'clock actually, 779. It went all the way to 799. If you see long breakout, this is the power of long breakout. And here, okay, let me see Bajaj Auto. Bajaj Auto opening itself, we gave above the long breakout here actually. At the opening itself, it went above the long breakout and made a high of 4344. From here, almost like 100 points move we got. After that, keep on coming down, selling the call options happening. And coming to Adani Enterprises, Adani Enterprises gave a long breakout at 12:45. So Adani Ports gave a long breakout at 1 o'clock, and Adani Enterprise at 12:45. And in case of Bajaj Finance, we got long breakout at 11:55, around 12 o'clock. After it started moving on the upside. So whenever the price is above the previous day high long breakout, never try to short. This is the important thing I just want to convey here. I'm now coming to the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty, what happened here exactly? Spot level, it's a go short level. Exactly after the market open, we just got at the go short level, stopped out three times. The 5 minutes candle, three times it tried to break the go short level and got tired and then started moving on the downside. Very simple. So this is a levels, power of levels. Always just monitor the level and you can make money without, even with mistake also you cannot make loss. If you just follow the levels strictly with discipline. And coming to the Nifty, again, slightly went above the go short level and started moving on the downside actually. And went near the pivot point and the zone here between the previous day high and pivot point, between the these two levels for the entire day actually. So these are two things that was happening in the market today. And coming to the daily levels also, if you see, till the time we don't break the previous week high, the low. Previous week low for Nifty, it's around 15,132. We have a long way to go. So nothing to worry for the bulls as of now. We are above the cloud and the daily chart actually, and daily official also has not given any sell signal, and the setup for daily official is 10 actually. Let me just check here whether I put 10. Okay, I had to put 10 actually. So 10 is the setting here for daily official, and for in case of Bank Nifty also we not got any sell signal. Possibly there are 1 or 2 days after that we should get some sell signal. Just wait for that. And if you see the price signal we got here around 17th May, from 17th May, we have been keep on going on the upside. And here, wait for the downside moment, which can come which below the weekly, last week low. The last week low is around 34,371. So for this week expiry, I'm not expecting this level to be tested. We are going to be again inside the last week range only possibly. Unless otherwise there is a big negative news, something, Dow Jones falling or something, negative news coming. And RBI policy also there is on Friday actually, so that is also there. So till the time I don't see any big correction to come actually. Big correction is significant in case of Bank Nifty 400-500 points move like that, or Nifty 150-200 points like that. Correction is not is very, it was a very long time back we saw some correction like that. So let's wait for the correction, and if correction comes, just grab it. Nothing else can be done actually. As of now, the market is completely in the hands of bulls. Nothing to worry, and you have to do some intraday trades and capture some points, as I mentioned in the before, by buying call option or put option depending on the move, and nothing else. Hope you enjoy the video. So in case you enjoy the video, subscribe and like channel. Thank you so much.